Welcome to the first lecture in Electrical Machines. We are going to cover the magnetic circuits in lecture 1. So let us see the chapter objectives. We will cover the magnetic field and its significance. What is a magnetic circuit? What are the important terms relating to magnetism and magnetic circuits? The relation between magnetic and electric circuits. How do we obtain the series and parallel magnetic circuits? Leakage flux and how it affects the magnetic circuit, magnetic hysteresis and hysteresis loss, electromagnetic induction phenomena, Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction, self and mutual inductance and what is their significance, effective value of inductance in series and parallel combination, what are electromechanical energy conversion devices, torque developed by field and depending factors, induced EMF in rotating machine. So these chapter objectives cover these particular items that will be taught you in magnetic circuits. So first we will see electromechanical energy conversion. So what is electrical energy and what is its advantage in electrical machine? So electric energy is basically cheaper, it can be easily transmitted, and it is easy to control, and obviously it is highly efficient. It is generated from natural resources such as water, coal, diesel, wind, and atomic energy. So electric energy conversion process is basically the chemical energy stored in any of the natural resources is converted to mechanical form, which is used to run the turbine, and electrical energy is produced. This electric energy is being utilized either in the form of mechanical, that is a motor, or lightning load or heating appliances. So the chemical energy stored in the natural resources is being utilized with the help of conversion of mechanical to electrical energy. So electromechanical energy conversion, which has taken place between the mechanical and electrical field, is to convert the mechanical energy into electrical energy and vice versa. Either you convert the mechanical energy to electrical energy or electrical energy to mechanical energy. This is the fundamentals of electromechanical energy conversion devices. Operation of all the electrical machines, whether it is a DC machine or AC machine and transformer, rely upon the magnetic circuit. That is why it is very important to understand the magnetic circuit, because the operation of any type of machines which is electromechanical in nature will depend upon the magnetic circuit. What is a magnetic circuit? It is basically a closed path followed by magnetic lines of force. So any closed path where we have a magnetic lines of force is known as the magnetic circuit. Operation of all electrical devices, that is the machines or the transformer, depend upon magnetism produced by their magnetic circuit. So any magnetic circuit which is producing magnetism and that is being used by any electrical device, even the DC also. So you can see that in DC machine, AC machine or transformer, everything will depend upon the magnetic circuit and which is depending upon the magnetism phenomena. Magnetic circuit of devices need to be carefully designed. Since the magnetism is the fundamental behind the operation of any device and it is depending on the magnetic circuit, it has to be carefully designed so that the proper operation of the machine can take place. Let us see the magnetic field and its significance. What is a magnetic field? Magnetic field is a region around a magnet where its poles exhibit a force of attraction or repulsion. So if there is a force of attraction or force of repulsion around a magnet region where the pole exhibit, then it is known as the magnetic field. Existence of the magnetic field at a point around a magnet can also be determined by placing a magnetic needle at that point. So if you want to find the existence of the magnetic field at a particular point where a magnet is there, just placed a magnetic needle. So although magnetic lines of force have no real existence and are purely imaginary. So magnetic lines of force you can't see with your I, nor do it have a real existence, yet the concept is very useful to understand the various magnetic effect. So magnetic lines of force we have to understand. What are the properties of magnetic lines of force? So let us look and understand the magnetic lines of force by taking an example of a bar magnet. So we will observe the magnetic field around the bar magnet. So this is the magnet, this is the north pole of the magnet, this is the south pole of the magnet. We will see that the direction of the magnetic lines of force from north pole to south pole. So if you observe from north to south, it will be outside the magnet. So from north to south pole, it will be outside the magnet, and from south pole to north pole, it will be inside the magnet. So this is the magnetic lines of force for a bar magnet. Now it will form a closed loop. So if you observe the magnetic lines of force for a bar magnet, it will form a closed loop. And the tendency is to follow the least reluctance path. Now, what is a reluctance? That we have to see in detail, which will be dependent on the magnetic circuit. As we know that resistance is the opposition to the flow of current, similarly, the reluctance will be the opposition to the flow of magnetic field. So the tendency of the magnetic lines of force, which forms a closed loop, is to follow the least reluctance path, and it will stretch in chords, always trying to shorten themselves. So this is the property of the magnetic lines of force. It will form a closed path, it will have a tendency to follow the least reluctance path, and it will act like a stretch cord, always trying to shorten themselves, and it will never intersect each other. So you will find that magnetic lines of force are never intersecting with each other. It repel each other when they are in parallel and in the same direction. When the magnetic lines of force are parallel and in the same direction, it will repel each other. And these magnetic lines of force are the fundamentals for any magnetic circuit. It remains unaffected by the non-magnetic material. So if a non-magnetic material is there in the magnetic lines, magnetic field, so that remains unaffected. The magnetic lines of force are not affected by the non-magnetic material. So these cover the first topic on the magnetic circuit. See you in the next class. Thank you.